Dr. Zaki, could you also tell me, is Zakat al-Fitr an obligation upon only those Muslims who have to pay the zakah, or is it an obligation on all the Muslims?
Many of the Muslims, they think that Zakat al-Fitr is only an obligation on those Muslims who have to pay zakat. This is a misconception. Zakat is only fard on those Muslims who have a saving above the nisab level, as we discussed earlier. But Zakat al-Fitr is an obligation on every Muslim, unless he is very poor and he does not have the provision. Otherwise, it's obligation on every Muslim. And our beloved Prophet Muhammad said, it's mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, volume number 2, in the book of Zakat, hadith number 1503. The beloved Prophet Muhammad said that give one sa of dates or barley as Zakat al-Fitr for every Muslim, slave or free, male or female, young or old. That means every Muslim, whether he's free or a slave, whether he's young or he's old, whether he's male or a female, they have to give zakat. Zakat al-Fitr is an obligation on every Muslim living. But it's not required that a person, you have to give zakat for a person who's in the womb of the mother, a fetus. Though there are authentic hadith saying that Hazrat Umar, may Allah be pleased with him, he had given zakat on a child which was not born, who was a fetus, but that is optional. But zakat should be given on every Muslim who's living. And further it is mentioned by our beloved Prophet Muhammad, it's mentioned in Sunan al-Bayhaqi, volume number 4, book of Zakat al-Fitr, hadith number 7683. The beloved Prophet Muhammad said that give Zakat al-Fitr on the people who are under your custody, whether young or old, whether slave or free. That means the person who's head of the family, he gives Zakat al-Fitr for everyone who is under his custody, whether it be the children, whether it be the wives. If the elderly people, like the father who's also under the custody, he's looking after the father, so he should give even zakat on the father and the mother. He should give zakat on the people under his custody, whether they are free or whether they're slave. So if you're a slave, he has to give zakat al-fitr even for the slave. So for all the people who are under the custody of the person, it's his duty that he should give zakat al-fitr for those people. So it's obligatory on every living Muslim, unless the person is very poor, or he's very needy, like a person who doesn't have the provision, the stipulated amount for giving zakat al-fitr. If he has less than that amount, then he cannot give zakat. But nachit, as Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 286, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not lay on anyone a burden greater than he can bear. It's further mentioned in Surah Taqabun, chapter number 64, verse number 16. So fear Allah as much as you can. So if a person doesn't have the stipulated amount, if he has half the amount that is required to give zakat al-fitr, he can even give half the amount. But if he doesn't have, then it is not obligatory on him. Otherwise, it's obligatory on all the other living Muslims. The beloved Prophet Muhammad said, it's mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, volume number 9, hadith number 7288. The beloved Prophet Muhammad said that whenever I command you something, do it as much as you can. Do it to the best of your ability. There's a hadith which is mentioned in Sahih Muslim, volume number 2, book of Zakat, hadith number 2147, where the beloved Prophet Muhammad, he said that there is no sadqa for a slave except for Zakat al-Fitr. There's no charity for a slave except for Zakat al-Fitr. So there are some scholars who say that even if the slave that you have is a non-Muslim, you should even give zakat al-fitr for him, which is not the right ruling, where the majority of scholars, they say it is wrong, because you should take it in context. Because the hadith clearly mentions, our beloved Prophet said, it's mentioned in Sunan Abu Dawud, volume number 2, book of Zakat, hadith number 1605, our beloved Prophet said, that give zakat al-fitr for the purification of your fast from empty talks and obscene talks, and give it to the poor Muslims. So based on this, we come to know that a person should fast. He should be a Muslim. So non-Muslim, save if you have, who does not fast, so where is the question of giving zakat al-fitr for him? So, but naturally, it includes that it means only for the slaves who are Muslims. This is the right ruling, that you have to give zakat al-fitr for the slaves which are Muslim that you have.
JazakAllah khair for the answer, Dr. Zakir.